Jesus is my Savior, but He is not my Lord. Everyone loves Jesus as their Savior, but many deny Him as their Lord. They love all the wonderful aspects of Christianity about being saved and forgiven by Jesus, but when it comes to serving Him, they are nowhere to be found. So I must ask, is Jesus just your Savior, or is He your Lord too? Can you honestly say along with the apostles that you are a bondservant of Christ? How easy is it to accept Jesus as our Savior, but how much more difficult is it to submit our lives to Him and to put our complete faith in Him? Let us meditate on the story of the rich young man that approached Jesus. He inquired of Jesus how he can attain eternal life, and Jesus replied, "Obey the law." And the man replied confidently and said, "I have kept all the commandments since I was a young boy." So Jesus answered him again, saying, "There is one thing you lack. Go and sell all you have and follow me." But the young man couldn't do it, and he went away grieved. Now many readers see this story and explain it away and say, "Well, this isn't a command for me. Why would Jesus want me to sell everything?" But we must understand the question the young man was asking. He asked how he could attain eternal life, and Jesus said to sell everything you have. How could this be? Why can't he keep his stuff and still follow Jesus? Isn't requiring him to sell everything making salvation based on works? But the answer is simple. Jesus was not saying salvation would come to him if he sold all his belongings, but Jesus knew the heart of the man, and he understood what that man put his trust in. That man put his trust and faith in his wealth. Until he was willing to give it all up, he could never truly put his faith in God. No one can serve two masters. Either you will hate the one and love the other, or you will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve both God and money. So, my brothers, do you put your trust in God or something you own? Maybe you put your trust in your intellect or physical ability. But Jesus is commanding you to deny yourself, to pick up your cross and follow Him. I so often observe many professing believers living in complete defiance to God's commands. They claim to know God, but by their actions, they deny Him. They are detestable, disobedient, and unfit for doing anything good. The difficulty that I have here is how someone can say, "I have given my life to Christ," and still live in defiance to Him. It is as if they do not understand that repentance of sins is an essential part of the Christian life. If you have given your entire life to someone, you will make obedience to them a priority in your life. How can you give your life to someone partially? How can you be so double-minded and unstable in all you do? Now again, my brothers, I must ask, have you given your life to Christ? How much time do you spend doing the things you want to do versus what God has for you to do? Are you neglecting His call, His leadings? God has a plan for your life, but you choose your way over His. Meditate on these words, my brothers. Make every effort to confirm your calling and election, for if you do these things, you will never stumble. Trust in the Lord, give your all to Him, so that on the final day of judgment, you may approach the throne of God with confidence, as He will proclaim to you, "Well done, my good and faithful servant." May I share with you a beautiful poem that is inscribed on the wall of Lübeck Cathedral in Germany. "Ye call me master and obey me not. Ye call me the light and see me not. Ye call me the way and walk me not. Ye call me the life and live me not. Ye call me wise and follow me not. Ye call me fair and love me not. If I condemn you, blame me not. Ye call me rich and ask me not. Ye call me eternal and seek me not. Ye call me gracious and trust me not. Ye call me noble and serve me not. Ye call me mighty and honor me not. Ye call me just and fear me not. If I condemn you, blame me not. Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but the one who does the will of my Father who is in heaven. On that day, many will say to me, 'Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name, and cast out demons in your name, and do many mighty works in your name?' And then I will declare to them, 'I never knew you. Depart from me, you workers of lawlessness.' Enter by the narrow gate, for the gate is wide and the way is easy that leads to destruction, and those who enter by it are many. For the gate is narrow and the way is hard that leads to life, and those who find it are few. Take these words to heart, my brothers. Amen.